what are the key amenities they should check for when they buy a luxury home? And also, should you buy a luxury home in a newly evolving destination?
See, the point is very simple. Let's look at cars. You get so many varieties of cars and different models. Those who have got all the amenities packed into the car, etc. You have the the lower segment, the mid segment, the larger segment, and the super luxury segment. My view is, it's all dependent on the buyer. You have to decide as what you want. Many times people say, oh, I don't mind an economical flat, I don't want too many amenities, but I want larger space. Somebody says, no, I want a two bedroom, but I want it packed with full amenities and luxury that I would like to have. And because that's the kind of quality of life that I would like to live to. For the new generation is now looking at that kind of market. They're not worried that it is costing 500 rupees more or 1,000 rupees more per square feet. They're more keen to see that the quality of life that they will need, the quality of the apartment that they will have, the quality of the amenities that they will have should be top class in the world. So they demand that there should be proper clubhouse, proper swimming pool, proper education facilities, health facilities, etc. And are now willing to pay that extra bit for the purposes of getting that. But there are consumers who will say, nothing doing. We don't care. We don't want all these additional facilities, but we would like to have the cheapest. And that is what we would like to do, and we would rather keep it that way. So I say that the younger generation are now definitely looking at better quality, better luxury, looking at that irrespective of it, willing to pay a little extra bit for the purposes of affordable luxury.